Water can exist in three states: solid, liquid, and gas. When we want to get ice from water, we put the water in the freezer and cool the temperature down, and we get ice. So, how do we get water from gas? Well, we use the same process. We just need to take the water vapor and cool the temperature down. This is exactly how clouds are created, which eventually leads to rain. The sun's heat evaporates water from rivers, lakes, oceans, or even from plants placed in the ground. This creates water vapor, or water in the form of gas rising in the air. As the water vapors rise in the air, the surrounding temperature cools, turning the vapor into water droplets, just like we mentioned before. The air is filled with dust, and these water droplets collide with the dust, forming the clouds in our sky. When this process happens repeatedly, our clouds get bigger and bigger, and water droplets collide together, making them heavier and heavier. Once the water droplets in the clouds are heavy enough, gravity takes over, and the water droplets fall onto the earth. In other words, it rains. In the summer, it's hot, and water vapor remains as a gas, leading to fewer water droplets in the clouds that are heavy enough to fall as rain. Did you know when you combine all the colors in the world, you get the color white? That's exactly what the light coming from the sun is, a combination of all the existing colors. And that's the reason the clouds are white. They're reflecting the light coming from the sun.